who the heck wants to buy snacks at a Home Depot? Like, okay guys, so this is day two of our trim project that we're working on in our living room. As you guys can see in the last video, when we were in Home Depot, we didn't have no measurements, we didn't have any direction. So we unfortunately did not buy enough trim. And we took 12 foot long trim pieces and we cut 2 inches off the bottom so that we could fit 10 inches into the car. That turned out to be a waste of measurement too. So this time we got everything mapped out. We know exactly what we're gonna do, how much trim we're gonna buy this time. So we're not gonna waste anything. We're gonna go right into Home Depot, get exactly what we need, come back home and complete the project. So in order to avoid you guys making the same mistake that I did, what I'm gonna do is enlist all of the materials and all of the measurements that we use, just to make sure you guys have a full list of what y'all need so that y'all not going back and forth to Home Depot. I'm in here for molding. He's in here for snacks. Who the heck wants to buy snacks at a Home Depot? Okay, I'm glad we brought a piece with us. Did you bring the piece out of the car? No. Did you bring the piece out of the car? You didn't drive. Here we are, yep, because it was 95 cents. Perfect. Yeah.
926 and the 193.
Okay, Home Depot trip was successful. We got in, we made our cuts, so we don't have to, I mean, it fits. We got everything we need, so we are going to get Mr. Man some snacks and back to the house to complete the wall.
Mama, look right where you calling me.
Where we at?
Chicken and waffles.
How the hell did we end up with
chicken and waffles?
I said chicken and waffles, but...
And I said Chinese food and beans.
And here we are at Buffalo Wild Wings. We were supposed to be on our way home to finish installing the trim.
It's a playbook. Try to be like your coach.
We got ADHD. Right. Okay, so Major and I are back in the house from our short pit stop at Buffalo Wild Wings and from Home Depot, and we are about to get started on part two of putting up this project accent wall. So let's just get right to it. So this is what we're starting with on the beginning of day two. You see here what I'm doing is just measuring out onto the trim where we're going to lay that next horizontal row onto the wall. Please make sure you watch out for your fingers. That tape measure will snap and hurt you. But just make sure that you're being careful when you're doing that. I have him using the pieces that we have trimmed cut, and he's marking out on against the trim where we're going to make the additional cuts to fit them into the previously installed pieces. It is important to measure twice and cut once, and it's very helpful to have another set of hands while doing this project.
Uncomfortable wall just disgusts me. Ugh, who would do that to myself?
This project really was a lot of fun to install with my boyfriend. And it could be really fun for you guys too. Just make sure you got a good partner to help you install, okay? Let's get back to work. We did use like the liquid nails on back of each strip, in addition to using our air compressor to make sure that each piece of the lattice is installed onto the wall properly. So once you have all of your trim pieces cut for your horizontal row, you just want to go ahead and just repeat the process all the way through. You see I'm using again that level to make sure that each piece of the trim is nice and straight before we install the brad nailers into it. And again, you're just going to repeat the process from right to left, lining up each piece of trim, making sure that it is nice and leveled. And like I said, guys, from here, you literally are just going to repeat the process from right to left. You'll do the same thing for the bottom row. The great thing about this project is it is ours. And so we decide what the wall is going to look like, how many rows, and you'll do the same for yours. Don't overthink it. You're going to know what feels good. All right, guys, so like I said, I did drop a list of all of the materials that I used here in this project. We have not decided on what color paint we're going to paint the wall yet, so we're gonna leave it for with that color just for right now. I'm super leaning to last year PPG's color of the year, Night Watch, so just stay tuned. If not that accent wall, something in my house is gonna get painted with that color, guys. If you have any questions about the project, if you're thinking about doing a at-home DIY project yourself, drop me some comments down below. Let me know what projects you guys are working on. If you have anything that you want to see on my channel, please let me know. Also, there is always somebody with a world of ideas in their head and don't know how to get started. So please do me a favor, like, comment, and super share the hell out of this video. Like, just send it over everywhere, because again, I guarantee you somebody on your timeline wants an accent wall, like, period. Okay, I'll see you guys in my next video.